Hey, would you make your own garden tower where you could grow loads of leafy greens and other vegetables if it was easy and affordable to make? If you've been on YouTube for any length of time and you were looking through hydroponic videos, you've probably come across garden towers or tower gardens. I've seen it described both ways. And I've seen lots of them all the way back from when I first started growing. They had some tower gardens made that held soil. They're like 55-gallon drums with holes in them, and you put a 4-inch pipe down the middle where you could throw compost and drill holes so worms would, come in and out. Me and my wife built a couple of those. They worked well in that, but if you ever had to move it, that was 55-gallon drum full of soil and moisture, and it was pretty heavy, and it was a little bit of a chore if you ever wanted to change out the soil. So we saw some garden towers with hydroponics, and that was around the time we started researching everything about hydroponics. And it looked a little difficult, and some of the ones you could buy were very pricey, $500, $600, up to $1,000. So that's why we opted out for like doing the downspouts. We were trying to figure out something else, that we could do. And this worked well for us for years, so that's why we've always been doing that. But I'm getting a lot of questions from you guys out there asking if I've done, a garden tower, or if there's some way that we could do it that was a little more affordable and that was easy to make. So what we're gonna do, I think this will be fun. This is gonna be like a challenge for spring of 2022, and this is for all of you at home. It's for other gardeners, and especially people on YouTube who have garden channels. If you guys want to make your own and we can all compare and share results with each other, we'll go ahead and do that. So stick around this video, I'll explain all of that. But even if you're just at home and you don't have the capability of building one right now, or you'd like to see us build it and see if it works before you make your own, then just follow along. And what I really need from you is your input. And I've been on YouTube a little while, and the way we usually do things is I come up with an idea, I make it, I grow something, I film it, and then I share it with y'all. And that's just fine. But I was thinking, what's better than just like one person just thinking of something? It's a bunch of people doing it. And all of us sharing our results with each other, right? So what I'm gonna do is go over a couple of the different things that I've seen. I've actually made a playlist. When you're done with this video, I'll link it up above, or I'll link it at the end of this video. I'll put it all over the place. There'll be a playlist. Go on my channel page and scroll down. There'll be a playlist that says Garden Towers. And if you check that out, that's some of the other videos that I've seen over time on YouTube. And they explain different ways to do it. And what I want to do with you guys is I want to go over a couple of those different ways. You guys give me your input down in the comments. Just let me know which one you think would work better. We're going to go over some of the pros and cons, and we're going to design with this video. We're going to design a garden tower, and we're going to try and make it affordable so that most people can go out there and get it. It's not going to be free, but we're going to try and keep it under $100. Okay, we don't want to spend $500, $600, $1,000 on something. We're going to try and keep it under $100. We'll see how we can do that. And we're going to try and make it easy to make. I don't want something that, most of us out there, some of us are very handy. Some of us have, weekend projects, or we have weeks that we can do something. I want something that the average person can get out there and build on a Sunday. Okay? So we're going to try and make it easy, and we're going to try and make it affordable. All right? Now, when you look at those videos, I've seen a couple different ways that people have done it, and one way is with, like we said, these 4-inch sewer pipes, and I've seen some people make it with these buckets. Now, what we might do is you guys tell me which one you think might be better to start with, and we'll build one. We'll actually get some plants going. We'll start growing in it, and while those plants are growing, we'll actually build another one too. So this won't be limited to just one. I want this to be a project where we experiment with several different things. And who knows what's gonna work, and then you guys can go out there and just run with it. I want to see these things like all over the world, people just growing their own food, okay? So one thing is with these pipes. This was the first one that I ever saw, right? Was just that somebody took some pipes and drilled some holes in it. Now, I've got this because we had our NFT system set up, and we took that down. The wall where this was, we're doing something else on there. That's going to be a video coming up in the future. But I don't like to waste anything, so I was like, you know, why don't we just take these and use these? They've already got some holes in it. We can drill some more holes in it. And this is about 5 feet tall. And I think this is a good starting point for us. They come in 10 foot. You know, if you want to get real industrious and you want to go 10 feet, you can. But I don't want to get out the step ladder every time I have to get up to the top and check something out. So I'm going to keep it around 5 feet so that I can go ahead and see in the top here. I can just walk out, check it if I need to. And it's nothing that I have to get out a step ladder or anything for. So if I do 5 feet, these come in 10 foot sections. You can cut it in half. You can get two of these out of each one. I think this pipe right now, the thinner one, runs about $15 to $18. I could be wrong. You guys correct me if I'm wrong, but I think that's what the price of those are. And what I have seen people do with these, you've got the whole, let me see if I've got a net cup. Hold on 1 second. Okay. So I've got a net cup, a little 2-inch net cup. Now, like these downspouts that we're making, right? We heat bend the ends, or the new way of doing it is we cut it straight and then made these end caps. They're available on Amazon, links down below. Cut a little groove in there, and these fit on the end. You just silicone them on there. That's ready to go. It's like really simple to do. And then you can take these net cups and they fit right in there, or what we do is just get a pool noodle, because these come out to about 2 cents a piece. They might be 3 cents now. The dollar store is now the $1.25 store. So there's $1.25 for a pool noodle. And you just use a pool noodle like that to hold your plants. Right? Now, so not too many people are using the pool noodles like we were. They're using these net cups. And the reason why I use a 2-inch net cup on mine, or 2-inch hole, is because the small pool noodle fits in there perfectly. And if people decided to use the 2-inch net cup, that would also fit too. So most people use the net cup with some rock wool or Hydroton, and we just try to do it, you know, cheap and easy here. So we were using a pool noodle instead of buying all that other stuff. Now, the videos that you see online, nobody's using a pool noodle, so you're going to see a net cup. And what they've done is your net cup, let me come up here. If you just drill a hole into the pipe, your net cup can't just sit in there. It's going to fall out. So if this plant gets any weight on it, it's just going to pop back out, right? So what they've been doing is taking this and heating it and trying to bend it inward. So you'll see them get a pipe or a piece of wood or a bottle or, you know, just all kinds of things. So they'll heat this up like we heat our downspout. See, PVC, when you heat it, it bends easily, right? So they would heat this and bend it. So go watch some of those videos and you'll see them doing it. And what they're doing is they're actually trying to get this to go in here slanted so that it doesn't tip this way. My thought, instead of going through all that problem of trying to heat and bend and everything, is why don't we just use our pool noodle? You know, the pool noodle saved the day again, and just have the pool noodle come in just like that. You're not trying to heat and bend anything. And the pool noodle is just holding it in place. And if you want to, I was thinking that you could even cut it at an angle like that, right? That way we can put them in here. The roots are hanging inside. This is at an angle to hold the plant a little better, so your plant's not gonna just droop over. And we can cut these any size we want. You know, we can cut them a little longer or shorter or whatever. So that's another idea. Now, another thing that they were doing was, instead of heating and bending it, I've also seen people, I think the one where the bucket construction, we'll talk about that in a second, but this I've also seen them use it was just to get plumbing fittings. Now, this is a T. I don't have a 90 degree angle because I used them all on our set here. If you can see right here, there's a 90 degree angle, right? What they would do is take those, or a 45, and they would actually cut a hole and try to fit those in, either heat and bend it or glue it. But here's the other problem. Come in for a close-up again. Right, you're talking about a round pipe. These, usually plumbing fittings all fit on top of each other like this, right? Different sizes. And what they're trying to do is take something that's round this way and trying to fit it on here. right? So, see what happens? There's a little gap, so they have to try and deal with that. So they either drill this out bigger and try to put this inside, or they're heating and bending this, or they're cutting this to fit this curve and gluing it on. Lots of different things. So instead of using a bunch of plumbing fittings like some of those videos, like we said, pool noodle comes to the rescue. How quick is this, right? So that's my thoughts. You guys let me know, am I just crazy? I'm thinking that would work. And if it does, it saves a ton of time trying not to glue or screw a bunch of fittings on, or heating and bending 20, 30, 40, whatever amount of holes, and just use the pool noodle like that. So that's my thoughts. Like I said, I haven't built one yet. You guys let me know if you think that's a good idea. You know, with these, you know, our little downspouts and everything, they've worked for years. I've done it for years, and I've saved a lot of money where I didn't have to buy a load of net cups and Hydroton and rock wool, and all we used was this. So I'm thinking, let's give that a try. And then you guys out there who can't get pool noodles, or you don't want to, you know, go ahead and figure out if you want to do it where you heat it and bend it, or if you want to buy a bunch of plumbing fixtures. But I think that that's going to save us a lot of, number one, money, because we don't have to buy 20, 30, 40 different fittings. And it's also going to save us a lot of time, because heating and bending these, each one on here, could actually, I mean, that looks like hours and hours worth of work. So the pipe's one way of growing. Now, one concern with that is the amount of surface area, wherever you live, it's going to be different, is where the sunlight comes in. So if you have the sun coming across this way, the plants in the back are not going to get any sun. You know, if it's coming straight up over where you live, you know, during your growing season, the top's going to get it. As it grows, the top's going to get light, and the ones on the bottom might not. And so whichever side you have it on, I don't think you're going to get sunlight over this entire thing. So unless you supplement with some kind of lighting yourself, there's really no sense in having a bunch of plants in the back. So that cuts down on what's growing here. That's why I saw somebody using a bucket. And what they did was they just put a bucket, which is about $5 right now, Home Depot or Lowe's, and then a lid, which is about $2.50. And they took that and drilled some holes, screwed it together, put another one, stack them up. We'll go ahead and check out the video down in the playlist, and you'll see, I think they had the orange buckets from Home Depot, and that increases the surface of how many holes you have, like on one side. So if the sun's coming up across here, we can get a whole lot more plants actually getting sunlight than something like this, right? And just the surface area, we can tell we can put a lot more plants on that than we can on that. So, let's see, that ran about $18. These, so that's about $7.50. Do two of them is $15. I'm thinking the 16 inches, 16, 32. If we do four, that's about 64 inches. So, I'm thinking that's about a cool height. You know, if you guys want to go taller than that, like I said, I still want this thing to be stable until we build it, get some water in there and see how stable it is. I'm thinking about four high, so $7.15, about $30. And then we're going to have a pump. If we use pool noodles and we don't have to buy a bunch of plumbing fittings or this or that, we're going to stay well under $100. So I think that's a cool idea. Now, one more thing we have to talk about is the base. You guys go check out those videos in that playlist and tell me what you think is the best. This one, like I said, if we have the buckets and this one's filled with 5 gallons of nutrients, that I think would be sufficient enough holding like three more buckets on top of it. So if we can fit about 10, 12 plants on each one of these, we're talking like 30, 40 plants. I think that'd be cool. Another thing we could do is get a big tote, like the 16-gallon totes, and they have the real heavy duty sturdy ones at Home Depot. I think they're around $20 or something like that. We can actually cut a hole in the top and slide this in, and we'll figure out some way with the pump, you know, drill some holes in here and that, But that base, we could attach this to it, and with that 20-gallon big container on the bottom, it's going to hold that and be really sturdy. It's going to hold a lot of nutrients. It'll stay cooler in the summertime, and you won't have to refill it as much. So that's another thing. We could get one of those big totes. We could drill 2 or 3 or 4 holes in the top and put these guys right in those holes. You know, I'm thinking we might have to secure it some other way, you know, because they'll wobble around. But we could put these in those holes, and that would give us 20 gallons for, you know, however many pipes we got going up. This could also, you could have this in here. I've seen people do that, you know, for the base. Like I said, I think just holding like that, there'd probably have to be something in the bottom to kind of hold it, keep it sturdy. So we'll figure something out as far as keeping it sturdy. But as far as construction goes, and you guys let me know if you think that something like this with 5 gallons on the bottom would be cool, or if you think that these guys should go into something a bit bigger, like a 20-gallon tote. All kinds of things we can do. So everyone, go down in the comments. Let me know your thoughts about what you think the base should be, what you think the holes. Should we go ahead and heat and bend them? Should we buy a bunch of neck cups and see what we can get for $100? Or should we just go ahead with the pool noodle? And just tell me your thoughts on it, or just tell me if you think I'm crazy, because I've seen these for a little while and I haven't seen like a lot of people building it. So that means that, number one, it's either too expensive, or number two, it's too difficult to make, or number three, it just doesn't work. So I think this is going to be cool, and I want all of you guys to be in on it. Either make your own tower garden, use the hashtag Garden Tower 2022 so I can find it. I want to look at it. I want to share it with everybody. And if you can't make your own, the best thing you can do is just to follow these videos and give me your input along the way, like this video right now. Go down in the comments and tell me if you think we should use the buckets, if we should do it with these pipes, if we should use neck cups, the base, everything. Just whatever you think is going to be the best way to do this. And we'll do that one first. We'll get it made. We'll put plants in it. We'll grow. And while that one's growing, maybe we'll try a second one too, and a third, and on and on and on. So don't get discouraged if like you have a suggestion and we don't use it right off the way, because this is going to be a group thing, so we can't do everything all at once. But I'm going to take what most people say. We're going to put it, implement it. And then we'll try some of the other things too, a couple variations. I think it's going to be cool. You guys, let me know if you've been looking around for garden towers, if you wanted to buy one, if they were too expensive, or you thought it was just too hard to maintain in that. And if you're another garden channel and you want to get involved, go ahead and build a garden tower. Look through the comments of this video. You can talk with other people, comment too. I don't mind. Everybody talk with each other, come up with different ideas. And you can build your own garden tower. Share the results with us. If you want to contact me when you've made it, and you want to just share that, and then when you grow, you know, we can do, you know, several different videos, or we can have live streams together. Y'all come on and just share with everybody what you've done too. So other garden channels, you know, this is your chance. If you want to get in on a community and we want to do something together, then I think this would be a cool little project. So hopefully we're going to come up with something cool. I'm excited about the ideas right here. After you guys give me your input, I'm going to get started building some of these, share it with you, and then we'll grow some veggies, and then it's up to you guys, and we'll share it with the world, right? So, like we said, we can't feed the world, but we can teach the world how to feed itself. You guys get out there, keep doing like you always do, live to inspire, keep on growing, and be the change. We'll catch you next time. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba.